And also, will I be able to drive with my chopper in the water? Yeah, guys, we can drive with the chopper in the water. Look at this. I do know that they're gonna start shooting each other here. Oh my goodness, I'm dead!
My leg, I got a cramp. Oh.
Yo, guys, it is me, Happy Cyrek, and welcome back to Last Dinner at Survival. So right now we're gonna go and redeem all of our rewards here from the season one. Because as you can see, I've reached here max level, and now we're gonna get this purple blueprint for the Uzi. We're gonna get a couple of the elite corgis and blah, blah, blah. But my feelings are still a bit hurt because developers teased that we're gonna get that AK grenade launcher, and yet we did not get it. They also teased that we're gonna get 100 steel plates, and yet we still did not get it. So now let's go, let's take all of the rewards. I'm gonna grow my puppies, and maybe I'll be lucky enough and I'll get that lucky puppy, because if you're gonna get the lucky puppy, your puppy will be able to bring one coin every single day. That's still not a lot. I would still say that this is some sort of a gimmick rather than a good change. So look at this, we finished all of that, we took all of my rewards. And also, I have really very quick question here. On the level 20, you can obtain your tactical backpack on a free pass, but recently I've gotten a comment saying that this is still a premium reward. So is this a still premium reward? So is there anybody who unlocked tactical backpack without buying the premium thing? I would like to know if you need to buy your pass to get this tactical backpack, which I don't think that you need to buy it. I think that it's just orange outline and whatever, but what do I know? So now let's go and take all of those rewards and let's let the puppies go. So let's take the purple one. Let's take the elite corgis, and we got here the simple two corgis as well. Now, oh yeah, and raiders destroyed my base a little bit, so we're gonna do a revenge raid very soon. And it feels really bad to go meet my new corgi puppies and stuff like this when I'm stinking, so let's take a very quick shower. La 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 la. I will also go and prepare 10 turkey for them, because why not? So now let's hop inside of the crate and let's feed all of my other puppies. And I just want to see what kind of blueprint is that tactical upgrade. Wait, I don't have that blueprint. And it is, oh, the thingy, I did not have it. Okay, that's it. This is seriously the purple blueprint that we've gotten. They teased us that we were gonna get this AK grenade launcher, and we've gotten this tactical stock. Whatever, now let's just open up these simple corgi puppies. So, Kobe. I think, you know what? Kobe is gonna be fine. Let's let him go into crate. Now, let's open up another one. Winston. Let's go, Winston. And now, let's open up this elite corgi thingy. So, this is going to be Boomer. Very nice. Go into the box. Let's go, Rocky. Let's let him go. And now, we're gonna have the last puppy to go. And the point is, I think we're gonna name him something original, because we have here, like button 3. We also have a simple puppy named like button, and there has to be somewhere like button number 2. Where is it? Oh, we have two puppies named like button number 3. Okay, so there is no like button number 2. And also there's another puppy named bonus likes. That's awesome. So now I'm gonna name this puppy something super original, like button number 4. So this corgi puppy is just for you. And if you're enjoying the video, definitely make sure to smash that like button, because it definitely helps out. All the comments and likes on the videos definitely motivate me to make more videos. So thank you for your motivation. Thank you for your support. And now let's let the puppy go into the crate. And I think we're gonna grow them up. Okay, so this is the like button number 4. And let's check out if I'm gonna be able to get any cool thingies from him. Careful and witty. So I seriously, he's level 3 and we did not get anything awesome. Okay, let's try to get another puppy to grow. Let's say, Rocky, what are you gonna give for me? Okay, Bloodhound witty. So we did not get anything cool from him as well. This puppy did not give anything cool as well. So I think we've gotten 3 elite corgis and I did not get any good skills. This one just gave us careful, and this one is just gonna give me well stocked. Well, that's it. I'm not gonna go and speed up any more puppies. We're gonna go and now breed these two pups. I'm gonna still rename him back to like button number 4, and maybe I'll be lucky enough and one day this dude is gonna grow up and we're gonna get that lucky trait, and I'll be able to basically get one free coin every single day. And in 4 years we'll be able to get like, what, 1,000 coins. That's awesome. Not in 4 years, but in 3 years. So right now, we're gonna be raiding this base, and I've definitely spent way too much time talking about the puppies. I was just excited. I really hope that I will be able to show for you that lucky corgi puppy. I hope we're gonna get him, and apparently today, luck is not on my side. I'm not even sure if you can get that lucky skill if your puppy is only level 3. Maybe it's only available when it's like on level 4 or something. But I really hope that we would get that lucky corgi. But in any case, let's just do the raid now. And his truck was totally empty. And I've done a little bit of research on this base, and I have literally no idea what kind of loot we're gonna get here. All I know is that this base is gonna have 4 chests. So I'm gonna give it a try. Maybe, who knows, we're gonna get there like 100 MGLs or something. But Eric, it's not possible. Whatever, let's go. Let's destroy this door and we're gonna go and raid this amazing base. Imagine you have like 200 rating reputation. I think by this point, like a lot of players have those 200 reputation and you keep getting those bases. It's kind of sad why those bases are even in the database, but at least this dude has the CB radio assembled. Wait, and a wave of zombies have spawned. Are you kidding me? Did I upgrade the guns? Yeah, because most of you probably already know that I tend to go to the raids and I forget to modify my Glocks and then I make even more noise. Okay, inside of the first chest, we're gonna get a little bit of stones and that's it. Wow, that's super sad. Imagine if I got this raid on my first. That is really super sad. And again, right now I'm trying to judge these bases as if I gotten them on my other account, because before I would just always judge raids if it's bad or a good raid on this account. But for those who don't know, I do have another account where like level 70 or something, and I'm preparing there to go for my first raid as well. I'm trying to judge this loot based on my other account. Whatever, if it makes sense, if it doesn't make sense, but that's what I'm doing. Let's take here the carrots. Let's take here a little bit of oak planks, and still, it's not something super good. Even on my other account, if I would have gotten that, I would be kind of sad. Like, so far, it's nothing cool. It would be awesome if Doggo could bite the chest. I would tell him, go bite the chest, and he would be opening up the chest while I'm chopping down the chest here, but whatever. Let's take one red ticket, couple of heat sensors. Most likely, those two heat sensors are mine, because this is a revenge raid, so those heat sensors are mine because that's what they stole. And what, this is going to be the last chest and that's what I've gotten. Okay, I'm gonna also chop down that thing. Maybe we're gonna get some wood inside of it. So inside of this chest, we're gonna get some duct tapes, gasoline, this thingy, transistors. Also gotta chop that down. Any wood inside? Nope, nothing. And inside here, nothing as well. Will I be able to exit this base? Yeah, I was able to exit this base and it does not get Cyrex approval. I would be super sad and disappointed if I got in this raid on my other account. So I'm back at the base. And you know what? Probably we're still gonna grow this poppy because look what I've just found. When you go here to all the traits, and you can see that the only way for you to get this lucky trait like this, once a day brings one gold coin to the owner. So it's only available on the rank 4. So hopefully we're gonna get the rank 4. And please give me the coin. Thingy. Rank 4. And we've gotten what? Yes, we got the lucky thingy. That is so awesome. So actually, we've gotten it. I don't really know if that is super awesome though. Wait, I just wanna let my. Oh, probably in order to get this, I will have to get rid of my bloodhound skills, right? So let's say we're gonna get rid of this bloodhound thingy, and now I'll try to go and take this like button number 4. So actually, guys, this, your like button helped to get this corgi lucky thingy, so I mean, that's cool. Wait, do I have to feed him in order to get that coin or something? Like, passive temporarily. Wait, I don't have it. Maybe I don't even have to feed them. And now I just want to find the corgi at the base. Will I be able to find him? Where is it? Okay, that's just my dog. Look at this! This is the corgi! Wait, the one coin! I got one coin! Did you see this? Would be really awesome if he would just keep digging and brought me more coins. Well, I don't know. They look definitely cute. They look really awesome. But again, probably you guys know already my opinion, what I think about these dogs, what I think about puppies and Last Dinner Survival. They're definitely pretty cool. They're definitely awesome. But I seriously wish that there was less RNG involved into these puppies, because right now it's almost impossible to get your true friend dog. I was really, really lucky to get my true friend Doggo. And I do know some people who've been playing the game like almost for 2 years and they still did not get their true friend dog, even though they are playing this game daily. So it's pretty hard to get the true friend Doggo, and it's just completely 100% RNG. So if it was less RNG, that would be better. And now we're gonna go to the shipwreck event because I want to try out this snorkel mask there in the water. I wanted to do this for the first time, but then I somehow forgot it. I wanted to do that at the end of the video, but then I totally forgot, and now I just remembered it once again. So let's go to the wrecked ship event, and hopefully there won't be no boss. Wait, do we have to fight him once again? No, it's the same way. I think we fought him. Nothing is gonna repeat, right? Yeah, everything is basically still the same, but we can go in the water. So we're gonna go over there. First of all, obviously, you gotta go in the water like a proper dude. Let's take here the snorkel mask, guys, and let's hop inside. Let's check out how it's gonna be. Will I be... Wait, why can't I go more? I remember that last time I was able to get more inside, no? Or maybe that's it. This is as deep as I can go with my snorkel mask. Okay. Wait, do I have to take out my snorkel mask? Nah, the guys, this is the same. I don't know if they patched something or no, but I do remember that we could go maybe deeper. I'm not sure, but hey, this looks pretty awesome. So we cannot do anything with the snorkel mask. Maybe one day we'll be able to do something, but hey, I had to try it. And also, will I be able to drive with my chopper in the water? Yeah, guys, we can drive with the chopper in the water. Look at this. It is still possible. I have no idea how that's possible though, but okay. Well, now let's exit the map here with the chopper in the water, in the sea. Very nice. In order to do another raid, we have to go and deal with the witch. And literally, this is my favorite part now about Last on Earth Survival, is that it is super fun to go and kill the witch. This is probably one of the most exciting things right now, at least for me, in the game. So I just can't wait to do this. First of all, like always, we're gonna go and clear all of these floater bloaters. And it's really fun to deal with the witch when you're not using like any, let's say, MGLs, like any spread shots and other stuff. I'm just gonna use like seriously simple Glocks and just 3 grenades, and that should be totally enough. It's definitely super, super stressful when you start doing it, like 1-2 mistakes and you're basically gonna be shredded into tiny smithereens, and it's not really that expensive to do, and it is super fun. Like I said that so many times already, but it is ridiculously fun. So let's deal with the floater bloater, and I believe we are almost somewhat done here. Plus these floater bloaters do drop a little bit of these patches, so we're gonna be able to craft even more bandages. Maybe one day we're gonna deal with the witch here on my free-to-play account, but for some reason, I don't see why. I mean, if we're gonna get the task to deal with the witch, then we will definitely do it. Wait, how many Glocks do I need? 2 or 3 Glocks or something? I don't know. Hopefully, I'm not gonna mess it up. I didn't take too many Glocks. Hopefully, 4 is going to be enough. And the witch is definitely up the top, so we are almost ready to go. Let's restock on everything. These are gonna be my guns. And just in case if something happens, I'll be able to go and switch back to another set. So are we ready? Yes, indeed, I am ready. Let's go. Let's deal with the witch. So, okay. So first of all, I have to remember that I have to go and lure her around this blob. This way I don't get any damage. So let's just lure her around, and after that we're just gonna go and deal with other dudes. Okay, so they started spawning. I am gonna start running very, very soon. Gonna try to deal with some diseased wolves. Maybe would be awesome if I could deal with them, because they are definitely annoying. But hey, they did not spawn first, so I'm not just gonna wait until more of them spawn into one blob. Then we're just gonna throw here one nade somewhere here, like up the top. Gonna throw the nade, and now gonna heal, exit, and they all of them exploded, just like 100% perfect. Kind of wasted a lot of first aid kits. Don't be like me, be a bit smarter. But I mean, being a little bit dumb is okay as well, as it's gonna work. Okay, now let's find this blob. Where is it? Here we go, that's the blob. And I'll try to go and fight the witch, and also I'll try to fight these other zombies as well. Kind of sad that she regenerated her health. And for those who don't know, you can use here C4s to explode these blobs, and then these zombies aren't gonna spawn. But like I said, in my opinion, I don't think using those C4s is really that much worth it, as it's better to save your C4s for something else. And I'll need to change my set after this, for sure. I'll need to change my set after that. Just trying to deal with those dudes, okay. She's gonna do a lot of damage, because as you can see, my set is red, so I'll have only like a few seconds to deal with that. Maybe I should even change the set like right now while she's walking. Yeah, so I'll try to change my cap. Changed my cap, and now gonna change the rest of that. That's cool. So I changed the set, so now I won't have to worry when these dudes are gonna spawn. I'll just have to take a Glock just in case. So my Glock just broke. Let's equip another Glock. So far, everything goes really, really perfect. Let's try to deal her some more damage. Okay, when she's gonna start screaming once again, she just dealt some more damage. Okay, she started screaming, more dudes started spawning, she ran away to heal up, and now I'm just gonna run once again around this place, and we're gonna throw another nade. Hopefully it's gonna work perfectly. This is the last wave, so my set should be perfectly, totally 100% enough. Okay, they're dealing some damage, it's perfect time to heal up. Even, it lags it here, even on computer, it lags. Wow. So here we go, gonna stay here on one place right now, gonna heal, gonna throw the nade, waiting, healing, waiting, exiting, kind of failed, still some zombies left, like 3-4 zombies, definitely could have been done a bit better, but I would still say that it's like 95% perfect. Now I'm gonna get back to this blob over here, and we're gonna keep dealing with it. This is so fun. Like, what's so fun about this event is that not like you have a huge break and you can do it peacefully. It's like Bunker Alpha. This is so different from Bunker Alpha, because you don't have a stop. When you click here start, I mean, when you start fighting the witch, you don't get to pause. The only way when you're gonna pause is if you're gonna exit this place, and then you'll have to restart it from the beginning. So that's why this is so stressful and so awesome, because you just have one chance. You can't pause it, you can't stop it. And in Bunker Alpha, you basically, as soon as you kill one zombie, you'll be able to stop and do your other stuff. But here you don't have that. It's so stressful, it's so awesome. That's why I like it. And I seriously hope that maybe developers are gonna add some more stuff like this, because in my opinion, it's super awesome. I said that so many times already, but I think that only now I figured out why it's so awesome. It's because we can't pause it. You start it and you have to do it, and you're not allowed for any mistakes. Any basically minor mistake can get you killed there, and you'll have to start from the beginning. Stakes are high, rewards are pretty low. If rewards were even better, then it would be even more fun. But I think this is a common problem here with the game. Rewards for everything here are basically bad. Now we're here at Bunker Alpha and we're gonna do the second floor, but this time I'll try to use maybe some more katanas because, like I said, I've been doing and I've been speedrunning here everything for a really long time. So let's try to use a couple of katanas. Let's save up here, Glock here and there. And also another question that I'm really interested in is that, did any of you assemble and get all of the notes? I do know that some people already finished it, but after the most recent update, I've also gotten a lot of comments from people saying that they can't find a single note. Like myself included, I've tried and I can't really find any more notes. I'm not sure if that's a bug or that's real or it's just only me. Because maybe it is just only me. Okay, I should have taken here. Oh, with my doggo, we can seriously just one-shot them. Okay, doggo, thank you for helping me out to deal with these roaming zombies. But again, the best way to deal with them would be the skull crusher. Okay, let's sneak up behind the floater bloater. Let's deal with them. I kind of totally forgot how awesome that is. But that's what I'm talking about. The Bunker Alpha is definitely way more calm than dealing with the witch. Because with the witch, you have to come there prepared. And you just have one shot to do it. Here at Bunker Alpha, everything is super peaceful. You can take your time and think about it. But again, even for Bunker Alpha, you have to come here prepared. Because if you're doing it for the first time, it's going to be pretty scary. I remember when I've done Bunker Alpha for the first time, it was definitely fun. I had no clue people were telling me that I'm not gonna be able to do it, that I can't do it, because seriously nobody knew how to do that Bunker Alpha, and myself included, I had no idea. Wait, will I be able to deal here with the frenzy giant a little bit? Yeah, I did actually. I've done some crit damage. That's beautiful. Okay, let's take a Glock. Let's deal with the frenzy giant. Doggo, don't touch him. This is my prey. Maybe I'll be lucky enough and I'll even get 30 red tickets, but I totally don't think so. But if no, we're gonna go and shred the blind one because my Bunker Alpha is gonna reset in one day anyway, so there's no point to save here the bunker and we'll be able to get 10 red tickets from that bad boy. And it is seriously definitely fine. So if you're getting, let's say, bored from doing that Bunker Alpha, and if you have a lot of weapons and a lot of stuff, I seriously highly suggest you either doing it just with guns or sometimes switching it up to do it like more efficiently. Like here right now, we're doing it with katana. With melee weapons, we aren't just rushing through that Bunker Alpha with guns, because doing Bunker Alpha with the same style all the time gets boring. I mean, regardless of anything, you will still be bored of Bunker Alpha, because I mean, you're basically doing the same thing for like 100th time, but it definitely helps out a lot to switch up the tactics, to speedrun it like super quickly. Or sometimes do it calmly. Okay, we're gonna try to wall trick Frenzy Giant. Is he? Oh, I got seriously punched in the face. That is not awesome. Wait, I'm not gonna be able to fight him like this. Doggo, please don't bite him too much. I'm gonna go and lure him over here, but he's still gonna go and fight me. I'm not gonna be able to hide here behind the plant. Can I? Oh no, we'll be able to go, guys, and do heal the wall trick even behind the plant here. That's awesome. Well, let's do the wall trick because I am a bit bored today from Bunker Alpha. So, I mean, wall trick is gonna help me out. I do know that as soon as I'm gonna stop, he's gonna start walking at me. So the tick here, I mean, so the trick to do the wall trick here, you don't have to stay in one place, because if you're gonna stay here in one place and wait for him to punch you twice, he's gonna start walking from here to here. So you have to just keep moving. So that this way, when he wants to go, you keep going in his face, and you got the point how it works. No, sir, I didn't understand anything. Well, don't worry, because I didn't understand everything too. Okay, now let's eat a little bit of beans. It's so fun because here they're called canned food, but in Sector 7, they're called tuna, so I have no idea why. Okay, these dudes totally found me out. I could not sneak because I wasn't too close to the bean. And my doggo got tired. This is so sad. Wish we got more treats from that Season 1 pass. Like, it's so weird. Like, Season 1 was such a disappointment. I think I said this really, really a lot as well, but only a few people enjoyed the Season 1. But I think most of the players really didn't like the Season 1 because I think rewards could have been a bit better, tasks could have been a bit better. And nobody's asking, you know, for like those huge rewards, like, hey, give us 1,000 steel, even though I wouldn't say no to that. But like getting at least a couple of unique rewards, like getting something awesome at the very end would be better. Because even though we've gotten these corgi puppies, but like, are they really that useful getting like one coin every day? Yay, that's so awesome. Like, wow. Like in 1 year, I'm gonna get 300 coins. Like, that's so beautiful. And again, I'll have to probably log in every single day and look at my corgi in order to get that one coin. Still not sure how that works, but I'm pretty sure he has to be fed. You have to log in the game and you have to put him in that hot bar, and then you have to find him on the thingy to get just that one coin, as we did today. So it's really hard just for one coin. It's seriously a lot of work. Just explaining all of that makes me like, dude, I don't care about that one coin then. Like, I think that getting that one coin is pretty cool, you know, if you want to change your appearance or something, that would be better. But again, just getting that corgi puppy is going to be insanely hard. Maybe in the future, more people will be able to unlock those corgi puppies, but you'll be able to find them somewhere else. Because as of right now, you could get only like these two corgi puppies from the survival guide in the free-to-play version if you're going to finish it completely, right? But those are going to be simple corgi puppies. You're going to breed them and you're going to get level 2 corgi puppies. So you're still not going to get any coins. So and otherwise it's impossible to find them. Maybe we'll be able to find them next time, but as of right now, it's not really that cool. As a premium reward, I hoped something better, seriously. Like I already said, all those premium rewards here should be like free-to-play rewards. All of these season rewards look like more as a free-to-play reward, seriously. I wish all of these rewards that we've gotten in premium, they would go to the free rewards as well, and premium should have something else, because free-to-play rewards are definitely pretty sad, besides the tactical backpack, if you can even get the tactical backpack. Because like I said, some people mentioned that this is a premium reward, that tactical backpack, but I don't think so. I think that you can get it as well, not sure. Well, I'm gonna know that. We're gonna read the comments and I'll learn it. And there's nothing much we can do about it. We can just hope that season 2 is going to be better, that we're gonna get an ATV. We've done the poll and like 50-60% of you hope for the ATV. So most of you still have hope in it. And myself included, I do have hope that we are gonna get ATV. So let's just hope that we're gonna get it and that they're not gonna mess it up, that it will be seriously a great update, that swamp location is gonna be the best. Because in my opinion, why we still haven't gotten it is because it takes time to add good rewards. Because as you can see yourself, no matter how cool location is, if it's gonna have bad rewards, it's gonna have bad rewards. Because if now with, let's say, with a season 2, we're gonna get the ATV, we're gonna get our swamp location, but rewards there are gonna be really bad, and if it's not gonna be that much worth it, then no one is gonna go to that swamp location. It's gonna be super hard to get there because you will need to get 200 engine parts, and if it's not that fun, then it's going to be a pretty bad update. So hopefully they will seriously do it really good, because like basically this ATV's been in development probably since the beginning of the game, because everybody's been waiting for that ATV since the beginning of the game. So they've been working on that ATV now for like what, 2 years now. So hopefully it will be perfect, but again, that's just at least what I'm hoping for. And now we're gonna go and try to deal with another frenzy giant. So what I've heard, the trick to deal with these frenzy giants is that you have to come as close as you can, not as close as you can, but as far as you can, but so that your character would not walk automatically. So from this place, if I'm gonna punch him, okay, so that worked. But if I would go a little bit too far, my character would do like a little bit of a step, and then frenzy giant would aggro on me. So you have to come as far as you can so that your character does not move automatically when you attack. Because before, you could go as far as you can, as soon as you see frenzy giant on range, you could just attack him and frenzy giant would not punch you back in the face, but now he does punch you back in the face. Another thing that I want to know, like seriously, is just out of curiosity, will I be able to do here the wall trick? Okay, I can't. No, I can't. Okay, that's cool. He can definitely beat me up through the fence. Did not expect this. I mean, kind of expected, because we can totally shoot him through that fence. So why not him punch me through the fence as well? But the more you know, totally did not know it. Because if somebody would have asked me, Sire, can you do the wall trick on the fence? I'll be like, I have no idea. Never tried. But now I'll be like, yep, I tried and you can't do it because I got punched in the face. Okay, one more frenzy giant. Let's deal with that bad boy. And we're going to go for another raid. That is awesome. So just this frenzy giant and 2 more toxic bombs. Let's try to deal with them with these katana. And that's it. So I have 21 red ticket. Oh yeah, after that, we're also gonna go and deal with the blind one. And another frenzy giant. Are you kidding me? Totally forgot about that bad boy. So we're gonna also open up now red crate. Maybe I'll get some gas tanks. But again, I'm still losing hope that I'll ever unlock that Leviathan. It would be really, really beautiful if I ever did unlock it. But now it's just ridiculously expensive. We're like at level 32 or something. And now the price is just insane. You have to give her like a bunch of gas tanks, like 3 or 4 or even 5 gas tanks just to level up. Like that's nuts. I definitely hope and I kind of predict that developers will nerf the gas station and you will need to give less stuff over there because it's just too expensive. So now we're gonna go and activate this hard mode bunker. I took a couple of shotguns from the very, very first floor. It's actually the top floor 0 or whatever from the ground floor. Yeah, probably the ground floor. Okay, I don't have any water, so we're just gonna eat food. That's good. Okay, so we are here at the 3rd floor. Let's deal with those slaughter bloaters quickly, quickly, quickly. Into tiny smithereens, I said. And then we will also destroy the blind one into tiny smithereens. We're gonna open up red crate. We'll get a gas tank. But Zarek, how do you know that you'll get a gas tank? I don't know. Maybe I'm just hoping for it. I have a feeling that the day will come. Like, seriously, every time I level up there at the gas station, I get closer and closer to unlocking that Leviathan pattern. And from some things... Okay, almost exploded. But from some things I've heard, from what people have told me, is that the max level there is like... level 72 or level 73. I'm not sure if that's real or no, but the max level you can reach at the gas station is like level 70. And at level 30, a level 32 or something, it's already ridiculously expensive. So I can't just imagine how many items you'll have to give for her to just level up, let's say from level 60 to level 61. It's just insane. So that is the only thing that disappoints me a lot, because I believe that I won't be able to ever max it out. And I don't think someone will ever be able to max it out. I think it will take a couple of years for someone to max out their bicycle fully. Not bicycle, but bike. I keep confusing that, but whatever. Okay, let's deal with these toxic bombs. And I don't know, I'm just seriously hoping the developers are gonna do something with the gas station, because it's impossible. I'm just a simple man. How am I supposed to get all of these resources every day? And even if I get those resources, it will still take forever to do it. Imagine getting 3 stacks of bolts, 3 stacks of transistors, and 3 stacks of bolt bearings every single day. Like, that's insane. Like, how are you supposed to do it? Even if you're gonna farm these zones all the time, even if you're gonna pick up everything all the time, you aren't gonna be able to get this many bolt bearings, this many bolts every single day. Okay, let's try to deal with this dude quickly. Here we go. He's shredded into smithereens. And now, let's open inside. Let's activate the password. I mean, let's put in the password. Gonna take 2 shotguns, maybe. And we are gonna just try to deal here with the blind one. We'll see how that's gonna work. Okay, the blind one, show me what you've got. We also haven't gotten any new permanent bosses for a really long time. But now I think with those season 1 updates and stuff like that, with those season updates, because now I believe we're gonna get season 2, season 3, season 4. So we're gonna be getting like those big single player updates now instead of the long ones. And at least now that means that we should be able to get at least new season every month, probably. Because I don't think it's like season 1 is gonna end and then for another month, we're not gonna get a new update. At least now we're gonna know the at least approximate date of another update, so that's a plus. At least I'm just hoping for that. I hope the developers aren't gonna wait another month just to release season 2, because that will be really sad and really disappointing. So now we're gonna activate another thingy over here. Boom, activated it. Very nice. Let's also take the sprint skill. Here we go. We took the sprint skill. Don't shred me to smithereens, Mr. Blind One. Okay, we shredded him. We got a little bit of I wanted to say we got a little bit of experience, but we totally did not get any experience with level 200. And let's take the red tickets. Let's open up now the red crate. Maybe we're gonna get a CFO. That would be very nice. And then we're just gonna hope for a raid. We'll see. What kind of a 3x3 good old stone room we're gonna get now? Boom, let's open up the red crate. And inside, like I said, gas tank, 4 shotguns, and like something else cool. We got 3 AKs, awesome. No C4 and a chopper wheel. Could have been worse. At least we got 3 AKs. I love that. I do know that it's possible to get an AK grenade launcher from those red crates. At least that's what I've gotten in my free-to-play account. I think it's super rare or something. I don't know. So after 84 years of sorting out the inventory, we're gonna go now and raid this base named DKH. And as always, I've done some research on it, and I have no idea what kind of loot we're gonna get inside. And by the looks of it, this is a pretty small base, but I might be a little bit mistaken. I've just literally seen 1 second a screenshot of the base, and that's it then. And the rest is just mystery for me. So let's check out the truck. Truck is just totally empty. Not really empty, one empty can, but whatever. So I think we're gonna come inside of this base from over here. And is this seriously the entire base? I do know that inside here. Okay, so no chests. I thought that at least we're gonna get a couple of chests. Wait, so I'll try to go to the top. That's it, seriously, entire base. So this base is even worse than the other one we've raided. Why? Like, I don't understand what have happened here. Why do they deserve such a punishment? Like, all this work just for another raid, and this is what I've gotten. At least 4 chests inside. Well, at least we've gotten 4 chests over here, so, you know, it's not that bad. Maybe, like I said, inside we're gonna get here 100 grenades, 100 mil cores, or, like, something else. Inside of the first chest already, we're gonna get gas tanks. Yay. Not yay at all. So again, I would be probably super sad if this would be my first raid on the free-to-play account. I seriously hope that we're gonna get something better than this. Okay, now let's deal with the wave of zombies. I realized that I haven't used snap transition this entire day today, so let's do it. I will definitely pick up those transistors and bull bearings because we need to give them to Jennifer, and this is probably the only way to get those transistors and other stuff, like, quickly. But it's still impossible to get as many as she wants. So this is the last chest. That's it. This is the entire base. I don't believe it. I refuse to... Oh, nothing. Oh my goodness. This is seriously the worst base that I've raided in a long time. Gonna go chop down these workbenches. Maybe inside of the workbench I'll get something nice. Like, yeah, a little bit of wood. Please tell me that... Yeah, another wave of zombies have spawned. Definitely not gonna be wasting my Glock. This is the base, seriously. It does not get Cyrex approval. We are in our free-to-play account, level 72. Right now, I'm gonna go sit on the chopper. We're gonna go outside. Hopefully, I'll be able to hunt a chopper event. But most importantly, I wanna go to police department and open up a couple of brown crates, because I do know that now we have 4 thingies, so we'll do the brown crates. And we indeed got in this, plus we got in the shipwreck event. Probably not gonna go there. Maybe we should do the shipwreck event on this account too. Except that it's kinda... Well, I could get here 1 Glock. Should I... We could easily here get one Glock. Maybe we'll even go to the shipwreck event. We'll see. But regardless, I have to go to the rest stop event. It's just the point is, it might be fun to do the shipwreck event, but I'm not going to get there anything. I'm just going to get my set destroyed and I'll get like in return, like what? One Glock? Is that really worth it? I'm only going to get here 15 points for such a huge event. I don't understand why we don't get like there 30 or 40 points, because it is seriously a huge event, even though it's easy, but it's such a huge event. So I don't know, whatever we're going to do here. We're going to deal with the raiders. That's what I know. Gonna take here a couple of first aid kits. Hopefully I will survive. Let's take one Glock. Let's take here another Glock. Or maybe I don't even need that. Wait, I'm just gonna take here my carrots and we should be able to do it. Here we go. Gonna go around the thingy here. I do know that they're gonna start shooting each other here. Oh my goodness, I'm dead.
My leg, I got a cramp. Oh.
Let's go, guys. Let's retrieve our stuff. I lost my military backpack, lost everything. I started shaking my legs. I don't know why I didn't heal. Why? I was clicking. Either it was in a different slot or something. I do know that they're gonna start shooting each other here. Oh my goodness, I'm dead! You know, when you're playing on a mobile phone, you can see where your healing item is. Oh yeah, it was on a different slot. It's healing is on this button. Okay, okay. I was failing. I was clicking totally different button. Got confused. I was clicking F because F, whatever, it doesn't matter. I was clicking F being my self-respect. Well, at least we have here some more armor. Okay, so I'm gonna craft. Okay, still need a couple of iron plates. Let's take here. Where's the iron plate? Here we go. We do have iron plates. Let's craft now this reinforced beanie thingy. And I'm not sure if I'll be... Wait, I gotta be quicker. Dude, the stuff is gonna disappear. I still hope that maybe I will be able to retrieve my stuff. Not sure if that's possible. Hopefully, I have enough healing items. Gonna take here beans as well. If I lose here, I lose everything. I'm risking everything. Maybe I should take a VSS, dude. I am gonna take a VSS right now. If I lose VSS, that'll be even worse. I have a SWAT set. Gotta equip the SWAT set. You might be like, Sarek, you're just scared. Yes, I am scared. Gonna craft quickly a simple backpack. Dude, I gotta be quick or it is gonna disappear. Please be there. I'm not sure if my body will disappear. You know what? I am already a... I'm already fine with it. If I lost my body, it is okay. I totally couldn't. I was spamming wrong button with healing. I was spamming and my dude wasn't healing and I just got lost. I wasn't prepared. They started shooting me because I just got... They surprised me. Wait, yeah, here we go. The chopper event is still there. They surprised me because I didn't expect them starting shooting it so quickly. Maybe I've spent too much time talking to the camera there and that's why events started going super quickly. Okay, on which button do I heal now? Okay, this is gonna be the Q button. Okay, gonna take the VSS and gonna deal with them very quickly because I mean I don't want to lose my body here once again. Well, that's it. Everything is fine, guys. Don't worry. Everything was calculated. I knew what I'm doing. I just scared you a little bit, didn't I? You thought that I died here for real. I knew what's gonna happen. Totally. I was just trying to show you that even if you die here at chopper event, you can still come back. This was a tutorial how to come back, guys. Don't worry. You really thought that I'll die here? I'm a noob. First of all, I die at the farm from that special boss. And now what? I die here? Well, at least I got three guns here from this event. So that's a good event. This is seriously a great event, dude. I died, but I got in three guns here. So it's all okay. The only thing that I wasted here now is my gasoline. But other than that, everything is fine. Let's go. Let's loot the thingies. I'm excited. When we died, something new has happened. It's not that boring. And it's something new. And again, more tutorials for you. More edutainment, baby. Seriously, guys, smash that like button for that scare. And I don't know if there's even that such a word like cramp, but I got a cramp in my leg. I started moving it so quickly and it was pretty sad. I seriously thought that I'm gonna lose everything now. But hey, being scared is the feeling of being alive, so I'm happy that we survived. And we got an M60. Please tell me we're gonna get something awesome in this crate as well. A skull crusher. Dude, seriously, that's... Why do you have to ruin everything? We had such a great combo. And I need to wash my chopper. I mean, not my chopper, but my moped is like totally dirty. But hey, we're gonna go steal all the gasoline from the other chopper. Amazing event, amazing event. Even though I died here, it was super fun. Like, tell me any other awesome events like this. Exactly, none. There's no other cool events like that. Even if you die here, just be prepared. And don't be like me. Be sure what you're gonna do, because I was talking. I wanted to say that, hey, look, they're gonna start shooting each other. It will be easy. And as soon as I wanted to say this, they started shooting each other. So I got confused. I got lost. Like, what is going on? And then everything went south. And dude, and then I decided that, you know what? Let's educate you. I want to die here for the memes. Well, I'm totally ready now to go to police department. But before I go anywhere else, I just want to show you my Bobby the Deer, the personal pet at the base. I don't have a true friend doggo, but we have here Bobby the Deer. He still did not despawn. And hopefully he's gonna stay till the end with us. So we're gonna grind now a little bit of police department. Not gonna stay here too much. Like I said, just four brown. I already have here one brown. So I think we will even open it up like right now. Show me what kind of goodies are we gonna get. And this is going to be one first aid kit. Pretty okay. And five rubber parts. Okay. Okay. I mean, definitely not going to say no to that. And now I'll deal with those zombie officers, maybe even gonna do a couple of waves. And all I need, 3 extra brown and that's it. I don't think I'm going to start here 20 waves because maybe tomorrow or after tomorrow, I will decide to do 20 police department waves here and we will do a raid here on this account. So I want to save it up and we have enough brown cards. So let's open that up and let's see if I'm going to get anything awesome. Well, a golf club, kind of okay. I don't think I've even started picking up golf clubs in this account because I do have a bunch of baseball bats and those are going to be way better than a golf club. And inside I get another baseball bat. So as you can see, not bad loot at all. So I suggest you checking out this video about the bear traps in LDOE, or click on the second card and you will go to my thoughts about the ATV transmission. Or hop over to my channel, go to playlist, and there you will find a lot of other games that I've played here on the channel. If you're not subscribed yet, definitely make sure to drop that subscribe button and notification bell to not miss any future videos. Also guys, drop that like button while we're at it and peace out. Mm-hmm. Yep.